Hayes from Swarthmore, Pennsylvania. Garnett entered the national semifinal game with a record of 28-3. Centennial Conference champions are making their first NCAA semifinal appearance in program history. Joined today by head coach Landry Kosmalski in his seventh season, along with senior guard Cam Wiley and junior forward Zach Odell. Coach, you can just open with an opening statement about your season so far and your march to Fort Wayne and getting to the national semifinals.
Yeah, thanks, Sam. Well, when you said our record, it kind of caught me by surprise. I mean, I know our record, but when you say it's been a long season, a lot of ups and downs, but mostly ups because our group is a really tight group, really solid group, and they've weathered, you know, all the storms, and you know, they just really have fun every day together. So every day is a, you know, it sounds cliche, but every day is a joy to come to practice and to be together.
We'll open up for questions. We'll start with the student athletes first.
Okay. I wasn't prepared to go student athlete first.
We said okay, so I'm sorry.
No, it's all right. Guys, tell me about what it's like being in Swarthmore's first trip to the Final Four.
No, it's a surreal feeling. You know, just to be able to still be playing basketball at this point, as coach, has been a really long season. We began practicing and training in September, you know, and it's been March, so just fortunate to be around these guys still at this date. You know, it's always a lot of fun. I'm really enjoying the experience since we've been here, so it's just a great, great feeling.
Cam summed it up pretty nicely. It's just awesome to still be able to play basketball, be around these guys all the time. I think we have a really tight group that enjoy being around each other, so just to be able to make this trip and be able to give them the opportunity to play these games this weekend. It's awesome. Awesome experience.
Cam, you've been a part of this program from when this kind of would probably seem a little far-fetched at one point. What does it mean for you to be Kirby's senior now and see everything you guys have accomplished over the last couple of years to get to this point? What does that mean to you?
Just that our hard work has manifested. You know, my freshman year, certainly playing at this stage was the goal, but it wasn't immediate result. And so a lot of sacrifice had to be made, and I think for us it was trying to master the details, doing the little things each day and trying to get better each day. As I mentioned before, you know, establishing a foundation for our program that we could build upon each successive season, and that's really what we've done. And I just, like I said, being at this point, my senior year, it's just indicative of all the work and the progress that we've made as a program.
What's it like for you guys on the Swarthmore campus the last couple of weeks with you guys making this run?
So our first round and second round, I mean, there was a lot of support from the student body. You know, Swarthmore was a really nurturing community, alumni, faculty, obviously parents and families has been really supportive, reaching out. You know, our games have had a very large attendance. You know, the second, third round, we were traveling, but we still had a great turnout. You know, people just at the game supporting us nationally. On social media, people have reached out, you know, commenting. You know, can't fathom Swarthmore basketball, like, you know, being in this position, especially historically, you know, how the athletics have been at the school. So, you know, it's been really, really great to see all the support from everyone.
There's a lot of words of encouragement from family and friends, from former players. We have a big group chat with all our former players in it, with the guys that play with Cam, and I think seniors from Cam with the freshmen, the oldest that it goes. And they're pumped for us. They're super excited. Obviously, Cam said they're part of the group, put in the hard work, and to see this result, it's just awesome for them.
What's kind of, I'll ask your coaches too, but from your guys' standpoint, what's really been working for you in the tournament to get to this point? And what's kind of been, I don't want to say your bread and butter, but kind of your go-to that's pushed you to this point?
Obviously, our team spirit. You know, just staying together through adversity, you know, that kind of cohesiveness.
spirit never wavered. I think guys were playing the same in both games. Just a lot of confidence and a lot of belief in the team.
Landry, you want to add to that?
Well, I thought after Cam spoke, he summed it up pretty well, and you know, Zach added it. That's pretty much what we've tried to stress every day, and the guys are living it. So I was going to say what Cam was going to say is that, you know, by winning games big, stuff's been working for us. We've been attacking, you know, playing well, but also, you know, playing well and staying together through struggles and times of adversity. So we're proud of that, you know, being able to play both ends of the spectrum.
You guys play in a relatively small gym at home, and you know, Amherst obviously is a pretty small place. What was it like being out there in a big arena today?
I mean, just walking in was really cool, and you walk in, the first couple shots, you kind of get used to it, and then it's just playing on another basketball court. That's what it comes down to. That's what we talked about beforehand, and the dimensions are the same. The hoops are 10 feet tall. It's just another court.
Did you take out a tape measure? I've been dying for someone to take out a tape measure.
It was measures. Tempting, being in Indiana. It was definitely tempting. And those guys have probably seen the movie, but it's also before their time a little bit, so I didn't want to do it and have, you know, 14 of them look at me cross-eyed, so I decided to hold on.
Cam, can I ask you a little bit more as more of an outside shooter, with what the shooting angles are like and such?
You know, it's about muscle memory at this point. You know, I thought I was shooting pretty well in practice. You know, we got a good feel for the rims. I think free throws were looking good. So I'm just about, you know, keeping your eye on the rim and just trying to knock it down. I think because it's such a high ceiling, you know, you don't want to look too far into the stands or kind of just keep within the confines of the court. It's just another basketball court.
We'll open up questions for Coach also.
Coach, what's the goal of a practice today? What are you trying to get accomplished?
Today, we said our number one goal is to be true to who we are and not change because we're in a different state or a different gym, but just do and, you know, practice and talk and give effort and focus just like we would if we were back in our gym like we did yesterday. So that was the number one goal, which I think we accomplished.
Coach, what are some of the keys to getting past this Christopher Newport team with a guy like Marcus Carter? What are some of the keys to getting past them?
I think our keys generally stay the same. It's kind of more about us, but obviously we tweak it a little bit based on our opponent. I mean, Christopher Newport, you know, athletic, strong, tough, you know, so defensively they do some stuff that can mess with you, and we've been preparing for that. And as these guys said, you know, we're going to fight through an adversity and stay poised no matter what they throw at us. Because this time of year, really, you should have answers for anything. You just got to figure them out, you know, as you're going.
Back at the beginning, you were talking about ups and downs. At 28-3, the downs are often still in games that are wins. So tell us a little bit about what the downs have been like.
Well, I mean, the big one was we lost two games in a row, you know, on a Thursday, Saturday, both at the buzzer. And that was early in the season when everyone was picking us to, you know, win the conference, and we started conference 1-2. So, you know, I think the temptation is to maybe, you know, get a little depressed about that. But we, as painful as they were at the time, we just said, hey, let's keep doing what we're doing. You know, we think we're doing the right stuff. We can learn really valuable lessons from those games, which we did, and have helped us in a lot of late game situations since. But that was definitely, you know, a tough time when we all knew we could be this good, but you're sitting at 4-2 and 1-2 in conference, and you don't feel like you do when you're 28-3. So that was a bigger struggle of the year.
And what about being down 15 to Randolph-Macon, right?
I think we were down more than that, actually. I was watching the film on the plane and said, I think we were down 19 minutes. But I think Zach said, and you know, you want to talk about really bad coaching, we never even called timeout, which was questionable when I thought about it afterwards. But you know, we have philosophy, we just want to keep attacking. So as Zach said, we didn't change anything, you know, just kind of keep doing what we're doing. And really we just needed to get stops against them, which was our biggest struggle. So once we started doing that, we kept attacking, we cut it to 8 at the half, and then, you know, the second half is pretty much even most of the time. So really just kind of staying, going possession by possession, round by round.
That brings up another question is, what's it like working with media timeouts? Then were you in a position at that point where you were waiting for under 8 or something like that and didn't get there fast enough? Or?
No, really just kind of caught up, and I just wanted us to keep going. Like, I didn't want to stop the rhythm, even though it wasn't coming our way. You know, we just wanted to keep running, keep pushing. I mean, in hindsight, I probably would have called timeout and would have talked about some, like, they kind of burned our zone a little bit. We probably should have made some adjustments in a timeout. But, you know, ended up working out because we didn't panic and we just kind of kept doing our thing.
Ask the players what it's like to be in that position, be down, you know, on a neutral floor, relatively far from home, and then come back and win that game.
I mean, the end result, I mean, it's a great feeling, but I think, you know, when you have, you're down a deficit like that, our focus was like not fragmenting, like not, you know, losing our talk or, you know, getting touches or, you know, kind of just fragmenting as a team. We knew that we just had to stay with it, and we lived with the result if we did that. That's kind of how I felt during that stretch.
Yeah, you're not really looking at the scoreboard at that point, I don't think. You're just kind of sticking with your guys, looking at them, making sure they're all with it, all still together, and just fighting to get back in the game.
Coach, you guys are a relatively young team. Does it cross your mind at all about experience, especially, you know, with two other teams that have been in this spot before? Do you think about that at all?
I did earlier in the year, but I think, you know, this time of year, like our freshmen, we have three that play, you know, in our regular rotation. And, you know, by this time of year, they're sophomores. You know, Connor and Ryan DeBoss are sophomores that are in the rotation. They're basically seniors. You know, they played last year's freshmen in the Elite Eight. So I think experience is not just by age, but also by how much, you know, game time you've had and how many adverse situations or different situations, like being in different gyms, how much of that you've had. And so I think, if you take it in that regard, we're pretty experienced, actually, especially with Cam, you know, now, and, you know, three NCAA tournaments and, you know, being our catalyst, so he can show everyone the way.
All right. Thanks, Zach, Cam, and Landry. Appreciate your time. Just a note for media that Wheaton will be here at 1:45, and best of luck tomorrow, guys. Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.